The stunning Pertamina Mandalika International Street Circuit welcomed MotoGP through its doors for the very first time as the season's second test got underway in Racing Mad, Indonesia. It's been 25 years since the island nation has hosted a premier class event, but that long wait is finally over as the official Mandalika test kicked off on Friday. The morning proved something of a false start, with the red flag waving early due to track conditions. But once the clean-up operation was complete, we began to see riders spin some laps as they aimed to get to grips with the newest track on the MotoGP calendar. And by the end of the day, there were six manufacturers sitting inside the top six places. Day one honours belonged to Paul Espargaro, with the Repsol Honda rider recording the fastest ever lap around Mandalika late in the afternoon thanks to a 1:32.466. That time gave the Spaniard 3 tenths to spare over the previous best lap time set by Toprak Razgatlioglu when World Superbikes came to visit in 2021. It also gave him 4 tenths to spare over elder brother Aleix Espargaro, with the Aprilia rider claiming P2. It's another encouraging pre-season result for the Noale factory after Aleix finished the Sepang test with the second fastest time, while they also managed to squeeze in some bike testing trying a different chassis on the RSGP. In third is Brad Binder, with the KTM rider showing some early promise in Lombok. The South African and Austrian manufacturer had a lackluster opening outing to 2022 in Malaysia last weekend, but a Friday P3 offers some early promise. On the other side of the garage, Miguel Oliveira failed to crack the top 15, and neither could Tech 3 rookies Raul Fernandez and Remy Gardner. They did manage to get some testing in though, with the RC16 spotted with a big new air intake at the front of the bike. Alex Rins and Shirt Suzuki are represented near the top of the timesheets, and he currently sits 4th following a positive track debut. Teammate Joan Mir is in 8th, while the 2020 world champion continued to test a carbon reinforced chassis on his second bike. Current world champion Fabio Quartararo was the best of the Yamahas. The Frenchman completed 86 laps, the second highest amount after Joan Zarco's 96, while the Iwata factory weren't spotted testing much equipment, instead focusing on learning the ins and outs of the circus. Completing the top 6 is Jack Miller. The factory Ducati rider sits 6 tenths off the pace and is one of only 2 GP22s in the top 10, the other being Jorge Martin. Like Yamaha, the Bologna Bullets' focus was on track time rather than new equipment, but there may be slight concerns over championship contender Pecco Bagnaia's opening day. The Italian crashed at turn 11 and finished 3rd bottom on the timesheets. There's still plenty of time for Bagnaia and some other riders to turn their fortunes around, with 2 more days of testing coming up in Mandalika. It should prove ample time for everyone to find their feet at the new Indonesian circuit, and you can stay up to date with all the action and hear from the riders themselves across the weekend on MotoGP.com.